Okay, so before I run out of time on this video, what I was trying to do is thin it down as much as I can in the early stages so that I just need to pressure flake the rest of it. It's a very stylized point, this one here. It's going to be a Gunther point. It's quite a bit smaller than what I started with. I had some cracking at the tip, so I had to take a lot of material off. I had some cracking that went into the sides up here as I was thinning the tip. It's a very steppy material. This lighter color material in Texas often is not as easy to work as the darker colors. It's very brittle. It's easy to chip. It's heat treated, but it's very brittle also. I managed to get this side pretty smooth, which was easy. This side here, it's got different consistencies. The bottom is a different consistency, or it's more grainy than the tip. I've got to hit harder down here, but when I hit hard up here, it sends in cracks, radial cracks in from the side. So I got to back off up here and then hit harder down here. But when I'm backing off up here, I tend to get step fractures near the edge where there's not enough power in the swing. And it just ends up going nowhere. And at the very tip, there's a little bit of chalkiness too. So I'm going to continue this on the next one. Hopefully it'll come out. It's not that big, but Gunther points are not very large. Not the ones I've seen anyway. Some of them are made out of obsidian, but I think the majority were made of chert. So I'm just going to use this and a lighter color so it'll show up better on the pad when I do the pressure flaking. Okay.